I am Santosh Gaidhankar. Today I am solving the problem of strength of material or mechanics of material. This is the problem of SFD and BMD. We have to solve the SFD BMD of this problem. Here it is, a UVL is provided with the point load and the two are reactions. You have to find out that part. First, I will consider shear force positive and this one as negative. Bottom I am considering as a positive and from the bottom I am considering negative. Okay, this arrow indicate positive and this is nothing but negative here. Now first I am going to find out the reactions here. Okay, reactions. Okay, before going for the reaction, convert into the point load. I am going to convert into point load. First this one is as it is, I will keep as it is here. I will consider as the RA. This is A. This is D. I am converting into UL into a point load. From the base, it should be 1 by 3. From the base, it should be 1 by 3. From this side, it should be 2 by 3. 1 by 3 into base. If you calculate, the value for this one will be 0.67. 0.67 and the rest, this value will be 3.33, and the load act is here 1 by 2 into base 2 into height 60. That means 60 kilonewton act downwards. Again, this is one more load here, I will consider as a RB, 1 meter, 1 meter, 1 meter. One more load here. Here 20 kilonewton. First I will find out the shear force, reactions here, RA and RB. Now how to find out? I am considering this bottom as a negative. I will consider as a negative here. RA. Next this will be plus 60. This will be minus RB plus 20 is equal to 0. Then it can be written as what? RA plus RB is equal to, we are brought this side, the minus minus get cancelled, and this will be, consider this is a minus sign and this is a minus common, 60 plus 20, this and this get cancelled, then it becomes 80 kilonewton. Equation 1, I am considering this as equation 1. Now I will take the moment about A. Taking moment about A, I am taking the moment about A. Now it can be, now smiling face I will consider as a positive and sad face I will consider as a negative. Now here I am holding this pen here. Now it is nothing but sad face. That is, I will consider as a minus. Minus 20 into distance, total distance here. That is 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1. 1 plus 1. This will be total 2, 1. Plus, now here RB is the smiling face, then plus RB into distance, distance will be 1 plus 2 plus 1. Similarly, minus 60 into distance, that is 1.33 plus 1 is equal to 0. You will get RB. RB is equal to 60 kilonewton you will get. Now this value has to be put in equation 1. Put in equation 1. You will get RA is equal to 20 kilonewton. Now we got the RB value as 60 kilonewton here and RA as 20 kilonewton. Let us go for shear force. In order to draw the shear force diagram. Now first, there is a load here. This is D, this will be E, this is B, and this is C. There is a load act. As the load act, we have to consider light left and right here. Now SFC at right side. At the right side there is no load, therefore you have to consider as a zero. SFC on left. As a left, there is a downward 20 kN. Next, at B, SFB on right. There is only one load, that is 20, that is positive. SFB on left. Left, 20 minus 60. 20 minus 60, it will be minus 40. At E, there is no load acts here. Therefore, you have to take single term or single letter at E, which is nothing but minus 40. Now here at D, there also no load here. Therefore, SF at D will be single term. That is minus 40 plus 60. You will get 20 kN. 20 kN. Now at A, there is a reaction force. Therefore, you have to consider left and right. SF at A, right will be 20. Now left, SF at A, left, bottom, 20 minus 20 will be 0. Now, right here, first is 0 here, 0. Second, A carries two numbers, 0 and 20. Positive 20, therefore 20 here. Next D is again 20. D is again 20. There is a single D here. Okay, E is 40. E means here 40 minus 40. Next again 40. B is 40 here minus 40. Next on the B it is 20. 20, positive 20, again 20 here, less 0. Now draw. This straight line. Now here, because of UVL, it is a parabola. Parabolic curve. Now again it is 40 here, draw a straight line. There is no load. Straight. In this way you have to draw the SFD diagram. This is positive, negative, positive and positive. Now we are going for bending moment diagram. A bending moment diagram. I will draw the bending moment now here. Bending moment. Bending moment now. Now here. Bending moment. SF at A. Sorry, BM at A. If you calculate, it will be 0. Calculate will be 0. Otherwise, you can do in this way. Minus 20, because it is a side face, minus 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 2 plus 1. Next, RB plus 60, because it is a smiling face, plus into 1 plus 2 plus 1. Next, here, minus 60 into 1.333. Plus 1. Next, now at A, and because this is we are considering is fixed, if we calculate it will be 0 here. It will be 0. Now BM at D, we are considering BM at D. D will be minus 20 into distance, that is 1 plus 1 plus 2 That means this value will be 2 here. Because of UVL, we have split it here. Next, plus 60 into 1 plus 2 minus 60 into 1.33. The answer is 20 kilonewton. 20 kilonewton meter. Now, BM at E minus 20 into 1 plus 1 plus 60 into 1. It will be 20 kilonewton meter. BM at B will be minus 20 into 1. Is nothing but minus 20 kilonewton meter. And BM at C will be 0. At this point, it will be 0. Now, draw on the bending moment diagram. These are the values we have to consider while drawing the bending moment diagram. The first value is 0 here. First is 0, second is 20, that means positive 20 kilonewton meter. At D it is 20, now at B is again 20, at E is 20, at B is minus 20, minus 20 means here, minus 20. Next, here it will be 0. It will be 0. Okay, now draw the lines. Here is no load, straight line. This is here UVL, therefore a cubic curve will be obtained. Next, there is no UDL, therefore directly join here, inclined line, and again inclined line, because there is no UDL here. Now you have to find out max. That means if we draw a curve, this should be maximum. We call it sigma max, a bending moment, maximum bending moment. You have to find out. When we have to find out, when it shear forces crosses from positive to negative, you have to find out the maximum bending moment. And here you have to find out point of contraflexure. Point of contraflexure you have to find out. RE. Point of contraflexure. You have to find out the point of contour. Now, when it is an inclined line, then you can consider this as a x. I am directly finding the contraflexure. This is a x, and this will be what? See, this will be 1 minus x. You can directly find out this value. How to find out? Right here, I am writing here, x divided by 20, you are right, is equal to 1 minus x. Don't consider the minus sign. Irrespective of minus sign, you have to consider the value. Then, with the help of the calculator, you will get answer directly as 알파 x divided by 20 shift is equal to 1 minus alpha x close bracket divided by 20. Don't substitute minus here. Irrespective of minus sign, you have to consider. Then shift solve is equal to, you will get x is equal to 0.5. This is applicable when it is a completely straight line. If it is a curve, it is not applicable. This method is not applicable. It should be a completely inclined line. The value for this one is 0.5. Now here, if it is 0.5, then 1 minus x is nothing but again here also 0.5. Now total length from this part to this point will be 0.5 plus 1. That means it will be 1.5 meter. It is a contraflexure point. It is a contraflexure point. Now we have to find out the maximum bending. Before finding the maximum bending, you have to find out this distance x also. You have to find out the x distance. If you consider this is a x, okay, I'm considering this is a y. I will consider this is a y. We have to find out the y. Again, complete distance you have to find out. It is very, very easy concept it is. Now, because of the parabola, you can't directly substitute these values in this way. If it is an incline, then you can use this concept here also. You will get the answer. But there is a parabolic curve. Therefore, you have to cut this portion. Again, you have to cut this portion. And you have to rewrite. I am cutting this portion now. I will cut this portion in order to find out the y length. Y length. I am cutting this portion now. This portion I am cutting it. And this will becomes a bottom load 20. And this will be x. This is x and this distance will be 1 meter. This is x, this distance will be 1 meter. Here we have cut this part. Therefore, it becomes 60 divided by 2 into x. Because we don't know the height here, because this part is cut here. 60 divided by 2, this is 2. If it is 3, divided by 3. If it is 4, divided by 4. Into x. Or you can consider as a y also, no problem. I am considering as a x here. Sorry, I have written here y. Consider, take it as a x here. Because the most of the problem I have solved xx. Don't confuse with x this value. Okay? Or you can consider x dash here. No problem. It is nothing but 60 divided by 2. 60 into 2 is nothing but this base into x. X is nothing but this distance I am considering. Or you can consider as a y also. You can consider the y also. No problem. Okay? Now considering the shear force here. In order to find out the x distance, first convert into point load here. I will convert into point load here. This will be 20 at A. Up to this point is 1 meter. Here we are converting into point load. That means 1 by 2 into x into height, 60 divided by 2 into x. Into x, and this will be, from the base it will be 1 by 3 into x. From this side it will be 2 by 3 into x, which is not required. Because with the help of shear force, it is easily find out shear force. In the shear force, only the loads are required, intensities are required. Now it is a bottom, therefore we are considering it minus 20. It is a from the top plus 1 by 2 x into 60 divided by 2 into x is equal to 0. You have to consider, because this we don't know. 0. Therefore, minus 20 plus 1 by 2 into, 1 by 2 into alpha x into 60 divided by 2 into alpha x is equal to 0. Shift, solve. You will get some value. That value will be, you will get the x value will be 1.154 meter. That means this value, we got it. This value is 1.1547 meter. We got the value. This is the shear force. I am considering the shear force in order to calculate the x value. We got the x value. The total length will be what? Total length will be 1 plus x. 1 plus x. That is 1 plus 1.154. The answer will be 2.1547 meter. 7 meter right here. The total distance from this part to this part will be 2.1547 meter. The x distance will be 1.174. If you add it, you will get total 2.174. You will get the total length from this part to this part. Okay, now we have to consider the maximum bending. I am considering the maximum bending here. Same portion I will use. In place of x, I will substitute the value so that I will get the answer. I will go for bending equation here. I am going for bending here. Same equation I will use. Here, this is 20 at A, 1 meter. D, this is unknown. This is D. This is unknown for us because we have to find out the maximum here. There is a line cut from positive to negative. D here, 1 meter. Now here we got the x value here. X value is nothing but this is the x value, 1.125. Substitute here, 1 by 2 into 1.154 into 60 divided by 2 into 1.154. The answer will be 19.97 kilonewton. Now 1 by 3 into 1.154, you will get answer as 0.384. From the base we are considering is a 1 by 3. From this side you have to consider 2 by 3. Because this is enough for us. We know how to find out this value. Now how to find out this value? I will consider as a G here. Pending moment at G. It becomes what? If I am holding here, it moves here. That means a smiling face plus 20 into distance 1 plus total length here. The total length will be here. 1 plus total length will be 1.15747. This is the total length, x value. 1.1547 minus, now it is holding, it is sad face now, sad, minus 19.97 into 0.384. If you calculate, the answer will be 35.41 kilonewton meter. The value obtained is, for this max value will be 35.41 kilonewton meter. In this way, you have to solve the problem. I am Santosh Gaidhankar. Thank you very much.